Hi, this is Dr. Subhatra. In today's session, I am going to discuss about the fiber reinforced concrete. So it is a concrete which has extra material other than the coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, cement and water. The extra material what we are adding is a fiber. It is a discontinuous, uniformly dispersed or the discrete fibers. All together constitutes the fiber reinforced concrete. It is actually a composite material. Maybe one type of fiber we can add it, or we can blend or mix many types of fibers and we can make it as a fiber reinforced concrete. The different types of fibers are steel fiber, glass, natural fibers, synthetic fibers. Why we need to use the fibers? The main role of the fiber is to bridge the crack. Obviously, cracks will develop in the concrete. In order to bridge the gap, to fill the cracks, we can use fibers. It increases the ductility of the concrete elements. And also, as it increases the ductility, it reduces the permeability of the concrete and it imparts more resistance to the impact load. It produces greater abrasion. Okay, then what is the toughening mechanism that is happening in the fiber reinforced concrete? It is able to absorb energy and plastically deform without fracturing. That is what is mentioned here. It increases the ductility of concrete. Because of that ductility, it is able to absorb more energy. It is able to withstand the stress also without getting fractured. So this is a stress strain curve of comparison of plain concrete, FRC with low fiber volume, FRC with high fiber volume. So when high fiber volume is used, the ductility will get increased and is able to withstand the stress for a longer duration also. So FRC with a high fiber volume is good. See, this picture indicates that when a beam or a structure is subjected to loading under failure condition, if it is without fibers, the failure mechanism will be this way. When and the same structure under the same type of loading, when you introduce the fibers, that is randomly dispersed fibers, discontinuous fibers throughout the structure, that is say for example if it is a beam, in case of failure only the failure mechanism will be in this you can see in this way only. It will not have a sudden failure. Okay, so introducing fiber has many advantages. Okay, so these are the pictures showing the different types of fibers: steel fiber, glass fiber, carbon fiber, cellulose fiber, polypropylene fiber, nylon fiber, coir, hay. Okay, these are the values which indicate the different types of fibers which has the different strength value, that is the tensile strength, ultimate elongation, specific gravity of each and every type of fiber, Young's modulus of the different types of materials are shown here. Accordingly, we can choose. Coming to the mechanical properties of fiber reinforced concrete. The presence of fibers does not show much greater improvement in compressive strength. It only increases up to 15%. Coming to the modulus of elasticity, if you add 1% of fiber, 3% modulus of elasticity will get increased. And coming to the flexural strength, it increases 2.5 times using 4% of fibers. And split tensile strength, it increases about 2.5 times. And toughness, on a larger scale, toughness is getting increased up to 40 times. And fatigue strength increases about 90%. Impact resistance increases about 5 to 10%. This is all will happen when a fiber is added to the conventional concrete. These are the factors which affect the properties of fiber reinforced concrete. Based upon the volume of fiber, based upon the aspect ratio. Aspect ratio is the ratio between the diameter and length of the fiber what we are using in the concrete. Orientation, that is the direction of fibers. Relative fiber matrix stiffness. Depending on these, the properties of fiber reinforced concrete will vary. Coming to the advantages. It has a high modulus of elasticity. It does not rust. And it can be easily placed. When ideal aspect ratio is used, it will give the excellent performance in the early stage itself. It has a very good toughness. It has a very high flexural strength, and we can cast it in the form of thin sheets also. Okay, the disadvantages are it is very difficult to work with it. Cost of materials will be higher. They do not increase much on the flexural strength. Then where it is applied? It can be applied in runways, aircraft parking, pavement, tunnel lining, slope stabilization, dam, hydraulic structures, thin shells, agriculture, precast concrete products, for manholes you can use. Warehouse you can use, in commercial building like exterior and interior floors, slabs, in residential areas you can use it. These all contents I have taken from this reference shown. Thank you.